In this video, we'll give you 7 tips to avoid issues with long encoder cable runs. While the encoder cable is very beneficial to give you the speed and position of the motor, with long encoder cable runs, you'll have issues with voltage drop and EMI susceptibility. The first and most common sense tip, use a shorter cable. It might take a little bit more design work up front, but it'll get rid of these nuisance issues and save you money in encoder cabling costs. Next up is to increase the voltage supply from the VFD. There will be a voltage drop from the VFD to the encoder and back from the encoder to the VFD. Because of this, KEB VFDs have a 5.2 volt supply for 5 volt encoders in order to compensate for this voltage drop. Another alternative would be to supply the voltage to the encoder at the encoder itself. This eliminates the voltage drop from the VFD to the encoder, so there's only the one-way voltage drop from the encoder to the VFD. Check with your encoder data sheet to know if this is supported on your encoder though. Another alternative would be to use HTL encoders instead of the more common TTL encoders. This would give you a wider voltage range of 15 volts to 24 volts in the HTL, as opposed to the 2 volts to 5 volts in the TTL. Thus, you have a wider voltage range for the voltage drop to be accounted for. Another solution would be to use a specially made low resistance cable that is designed specifically for long cable runs. This helps to reduce the voltage drop across the run. While these low resistance cables are often more expensive, it might be worth it if no other solution is available. The next solution would be to use a signal repeater. While often on older type machines that don't have Fieldbus available, these split, amplify, and condition the signal going back to the VFD. The last solution would be to utilize the remote I/O modules in a Fieldbus system. With this, the encoder feedback could be transmitted across the EtherCAT bus with runs up to 100 meters long. You'll just have to keep in mind that these have a 1 millisecond delay, so you'll have to make sure it fits in your application. If you have more questions, contact us at KEB America.